Hello, I'm Russ Burlingame, and I'm an author. I'm here to tell you about Best Movie Ever. This is my oral history of the 2001 Josie and the Pussycats movie from directors Harry Alfont and Deborah Kaplan. Now, this movie came out, it had huge expectations. You know, Universal was really high on it. It had these big stars. Rachel Lee Cook right after She's All That. You had Tara Reid right after American Pie. Rosario Dawson in one of her earlier roles. You had Parker Posey and Alan Cumming giving the whole thing gravitas. And everybody thought it was going to be a huge hit.
And this is not that moment.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. You're a great crowd.
And then it was not. This movie bombed at the box office. It was middling with critics. And at the time, it seemed like, well, that was pretty much the end of it. That didn't happen, though. Actually, this movie has gone on to become a cult classic. And everybody from the internet and the YouTubers to, like, really credible, like, the Los Angeles Times and BuzzFeed have talked about how this movie was an underrated gem. And there's been a lot of credible film writers who call it one of the best comic book movies ever made, one of the best movies of its time. And I wanted to kind of dig in to how that happened. How a movie goes from being a bomb that, you know, Rachel Lee Cook said put her in movie jail, and the directors have joked they never got to make a feature film again, to a movie that's widely accepted to be really great. So I reached out to the filmmakers, and that's what I've done. I'm talking to cast and crew, I'm talking to fans, and I'm trying to get a sense for, like, the production of the film, the reception of the film, and then the legacy of the film, and how this movie became, you know, the best movie ever. Aside from, you know, an on-screen Chiron. So why am I crowdfunding? Basically, I'm asking people to help me out with the cost of editing, transcribing, and distributing a self-published book. I've reached out to some publishers. My biggest concern is that I couldn't turn it around fast enough when we had an anniversary looming, and I really wanted to get these in the hands of fans. Now, I've been doing this for 20 years. I started my career at Wizard Magazine, which, ask your parents. This is not just about Josie. This is part of a larger trend in film. You can look at Kevin Smith's Mallrats. That was a movie that bombed hard at the box office, but then was gigantic on VHS. You can look at Tremors, which was a movie that got so big in the rental market, it actually spawned multiple sequels. And Josie is this interesting case where it kind of quietly bubbled up over a long time instead of doing it immediately after it hit the video store. And I wanted to dig into that a little bit. But also I wanted to dig in some of the cool stuff that everybody doesn't know about the production. I mean, we've all heard the stories about how Beyoncé Knowles came in for the role that was Rosario Dawson's, but there was a dude from Braveheart who came for the Alan Cumming part. There were some huge A-list stars who came and auditioned for this movie, and the directors were a little starstruck, but, like, it just wasn't quite there. These are the kind of cool stories that, like, you only get when you're going super in-depth with folks. And as somebody who writes a lot of really kind of headline news stories, I know that a lot of my audience always wants me to go more in-depth, and that's what this is. So I not only talked to the directors, I talked to Rachel Lee Cook about working with her hero, Parker Posey, for the second time. I talked with Brecken Meyer about pitching a du jour spin-off to Netflix. And I talked to Hiro Kanagawa, who's the Japanese guy, and some other folks who spent, like, a day on set, and how this movie has stuck with them for 20 years in spite of the fact that that was never supposed to happen. A lot of these stories are people who haven't ever talked about the movie on the record before. I talked to Tim Long, who wrote a Simpsons episode that essentially predicted the plot. Believe it or not, he had a lot to say about Josie and the Pussycats. Of course, the other thing is, this was made at a time when not every comic book was a movie yet, so I get to talk to the folks from Archie a little bit about the development of it and how they felt about the movie. I got to talk to comic book experts and product placement experts and people who had a lot of weird, different takes on the importance of this film that aren't just straight down the barrel, oh, well, people really like it now. That is, in spite of the fact that this is not a superhero movie, this is an opportunity for me to look back on the 20 years that I've been writing about people in tights dropping buildings on each other and kind of see where we've gone. Because this movie came at a time when superhero movies weren't a thing, comic book movies weren't a thing, and we were coming off of flops like Batman and Robin and Tank Girl. So the idea that now, 20 years later, not only do people love Josie, but people talk about it in the same breath that talk about Dark Knight and about the Marvel Cinematic Universe, that's a big deal, and I feel like I can contextualize it in a way because I've actually been there that whole time. So what are we doing here on Indiegogo? I'm committed to making this book happen in 2021. You know, it's the year of Josie. It's the 20th anniversary of both the theatrical and the home release of the movie. I want to get this book professionally edited because it deserves to be taken seriously. This is a story that's actually important. I also want to get it professionally transcribed. I used some of the AI-driven transcriptions that are really cheap. Unfortunately, it couldn't tell the difference between myself and writer-director Deborah Kaplan. That's a problem. So what I'm doing is I'm coming here to get the very basics of production done. I've already done dozens of hours of interviews. I've already done 15 hours of transcription. What I need is to finish the actual project and to be able to deliver it to the people who want to read this book. And in addition to just the books, I'm going to have some cool stuff here because I have mountains of things that I got for research, including these are blueprints from the set designer. Some of these are this size, some of them are 24 by 36. There's a huge one on my wall over there. Got a few of these Cattier headphones that were actually used in the big concert scene at the end of the movie. And I've got a handful of Josie and the Pussycat t-shirts that were screen-used props from the concert at the end of the movie and some du jour shirts from the beginning of the movie. These are things that they're really cool, but I want to get them in the hands of other fans because I know that the people who like this movie love this movie. And I think that it would be a really cool opportunity for me to say, hey, help me get this book in your hands. And as a kind of reward for that, I'm going to part with some of the cool stuff that I've had sitting here for a while I research. So you can see everything that we have to offer right here on the page. It starts at $10 for an ebook copy, all the way up to like a specially handcrafted, custom-bound version with a special cover you can only get here on Indiegogo. I want to get this in your hands by fall, though, so I've got to get back to work.